We are starting tomorrow at 9 a.m. with a whistleblower known as Job.
Last week, Parliament formed a select committee of 7 MPs to investigate claims of corruption and infighting at the National Social Security Fund as a measure to help restore public faith in the fund. Today, the committee sat in a closed session and set perimeters of the investigation, which is slated to take only 1 week.
Right now, we have invited only the stakeholders who have the mandate as per the law in as regards to the fund. However, if any name during the investigation comes up and is legally binding to the mandate of the fund, we shall invite all those stakeholders to appear before the committee.
Proceedings will kick off tomorrow. Mwine Mpaka, the chairperson of the committee, addressed the press on key witnesses that have been summoned, starting with whistleblowers who are expected tomorrow.
We are starting tomorrow at 9 a.m. with a whistleblower known as Job. Thereafter, we're going to meet the two workers' unions the whole day up to 6 p.m. And on Wednesday, we are going to start with the workers' MPs at 9 a.m. And after the workers' MPs, we are going to meet the Federation of Employers. After that, we are going to meet the board at 11 to 1 p.m.
The committee is also going to take interest in the pension towers, a project under construction by NSSF on Lumumba Avenue in Kampala, which allegedly developed cracks recently.
We're also going to have a field visit to the pension tower, and we have also instructed the competent authority to verify the claims regarding the pension tower, whether it had a crack or not.
The ad hoc committee was given only 30 days to report back to Parliament with a detailed report. The committee was handed 5 terms of reference, including the inquiry into the corporate governance of the entity, reappointment of the MD Richard Byarugaba, safety of savers' funds, among others, which Mwine Mpaka vowed to execute diligently.
We're going to look at the circumstances surrounding the appointment of the MD. We're going to look at corporate governance at the fund. We're going to establish whether the fund, people's savings, are actually safe. We are also going to look at any other emerging issues as stated by the Honorable Minister, for example, claims of corruption.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.